A marathon with a difference. British astronaut Tim Peake is set to run the London Marathon on Sunday, but from space. There'll be no cheering crowds and no risk of the British weather. Instead, he'll be in a room handily next to the toilet on the International Space Station. And he won't even have a view of Earth.
I'm very used to running up here now. I probably run with about 75% of my body weight. And I've got a harness system here I can show you. So this is what keeps me strapped to the treadmill when I run. And these chains connect to a bungee system. And that keeps me on the treadmill. And it gives me the weight bearing that I need on my legs to stimulate those muscles.
Tim will use the Run Social app to follow the full 26.2-mile route of the Virgin London Marathon. It picks up the speed of the vibrations of the treadmill, and that speeds up or slows down the course. Peake has actually run the real course in real life and said knowing what the atmosphere is like will keep him going. That and the people he'll get to speak to once he's done.
I'm quite fortunate that once a week we get a video link with our family, and mine will be after the race on Sunday. So although I won't be actually able to hug them, I'll be able to go and have a video call with them and speak to them in Houston, which will be great. I'll really be looking forward to that throughout the race.
Well, many people will be loading up the carbs with the pasta the night before the run. He hasn't worked out what he'll be eating.
Maybe some baked bean, sausage and egg fairly early on. You certainly don't want to be running up here on a full stomach. It needs to be at least 2 to 3 hours after you've eaten. Of course, food in microgravity, it doesn't settle very well. It just stays floating around in your stomach. So I'll have an early breakfast.
Tim's hoping to complete the route in around 3.5 to 4 hours and said he doesn't think he'll be in too much pain afterwards.
Actually, weightlessness, I think, is one of the perfect environments because the moment you stop running and the moment you get off that bungee system, your muscles are in a completely relaxed state.
Tim's not the first person to ever run a marathon in space, though. Sunita Williams ran alongside the Boston Marathon back in 2007 from space. But it's yet another first for this British astronaut.